سورة غافر. أفتر سورة غافر السورة فصلت. That a chapter was detailed, was explained in details, clarified. And سورة فصلت, it has a very powerful starting. And you know, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gave this beginning of سورة فصلت, he was reciting to whom from الكافرين. He was reciting the Quran for Al-Walid ibn Mughira, one of the leaders of Kufr. And when Rasulullah reached the ayah, فَإِنْ أَعْرَضُوا فَقُلْ أَنْذَرْتُكُمْ صَاعِقَةً مِثْلَ صَاعِقَةِ عَدٍ وَثَمُودَ. If they turned away from you, Ya Muhammad, tell them I have warned you, a صَاعِقَة. Like, صَاعِقَة is, you know, what do we call if someone light. Put his hand in huge electrical
shock.
So it's like huge shock from your Lord will come to take all of them. I'm warning you, a sa'iqa, a shock from your Lord, same like came to ka sa'iqa ta'ad wa thamud. You know what happened after that? Al-Walid ibn Mughira put his hands on the mouth of the Prophet. Please stop. He became so afraid, so scared. He knows that Rasulullah is Rasulullah. He knows that Muhammad is a messenger from Allah, and he was very afraid to continue, then the sa'iqa will come. SubhanAllah. Maybe one day I will try to give, inshallah, one khutbah about this topic. It came here in one ayah. And this topic is very interesting. وقال الذين كفروا لا تسمعوا لهذا القرآن ولا خوفي لعلكم تغلبون. Look my dear brothers, if you want to know your power, if you want to know the valuable things and precious things that Allah gave you, look what your enemy is trying to attack you from or are jealous from. If you don't appreciate or you don't understand the blessings Allah gave you, look to the enemies how they are trying to get this away from you. وقال الذين كفروا, and those who disbelieved, they said, لا تسمعوا لهذا القرآن, don't listen to this Quran. والخوفي, trying to make disturbance for anyone trying to listen. لعلكم تغلبون, perhaps you will be victorious. سبحان الله العظيم, الكافرين, الكفار, المشركين, the disbelievers, the deniers, the leaders of Quraysh, they know what is Al-Quran al-Karim. And that's why they try their best to stop people from listening. Don't listen. Never listen to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't listen to this Quran. The magic will affect you. And try to make love, disturbance around it. To take people away from the Quran. And see, do you think that this happened in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam only? What do you think? Wallahi, my dear brothers and sisters, the main reason that took our ummah away from victory, took our ummah away from being victorious, took our ummah to be in the bottom of the world, that led us to be in what we are, is that our enemies could succeed to take most of Muslims away from Quran. Tell me, out of the 2 billion, how many persons understand the Quran. Don't tell me Hafiz. We have millions of Hafiz, but we don't understand anything. How many Muslim from the 2 billion, give me percent, how many they understand the Book of Allah? Look how they took us away from the Book of Allah. They tried their best to make attractions of haram. Songs, singers, movies, dramas, YouTubes. Not YouTube is for everything, but attractions, social media, Netflix. I hate Netflix. This is Shaitanflix. Okay? Look how many things they are trying to take people away just to be busy and disturb the stream of Quran. To take you away, to attract you away, by all means. Sports is okay, but when it comes like the championships of that you see like in soccer for the Spanish one or the English one or the European one, that people will pay a lot of money and they will travel and they will go to stadiums and spend a lot of hours and days and weeks just to follow their team. And what are you doing? It's too much. Wasting your life. You can play sports, you can watch sports also, but if some sports doesn't include problems, but how many attractions they are doing? They know that there are people for the religions, Christians and Jews, khalas already, they are not practicing. And they don't have the truth to attract people to their places. But they want the Muslims to be away from the Quran. They know that the most powerful weapon Muslims have Al-Qur'an al-Azim. So this weapon, they should take you away from it. And if the Ummah return back to the Qur'an, reciting, understanding, applying, they know that this Ummah definitely will be victorious and they will defeat all the rest of the nations. They know it from the history. They know it from the history. I will just end up by this. Know Al-Andalus. Who knows what is Al-Andalus?
Spain.
Andalus is Europa? It's part of Europe. Spain.
It's near from Morocco.
Huh?
It's near from Morocco.
Near from Morocco, okay. It's in Europe. And it was the extension of Morocco when it reached Europe. And many can say it's Spain. Till now, if you had a chance to go to Spain, you will find the Arabic names still there. Arabic names of the areas and the castles and the masajid of this empire, this kingdom. Al-Andalus, you know, in the past, in the beginning, they were very strong Muslims. MashaAllah. The enemies sent some spies to check. How is the youth like Abdullah and Yusuf? Like 13, 14, 15, 18, 20. How is those people doing? They sent spies to check what they are doing. They found them, yeah, Abdullah and Yusuf, what they are doing. They found the two boys sitting together and what? They are checking the memorization of each other, not in Quran, in Sahih Bukhari, said, never ever try to attack these people right now. If the youth, they finish the Quran and they are competing each other and correcting the memorization of Sahih Bukhari, then they have very strong deen, they will defeat us definitely. After long years, they send the fitna of women, alcohol, singing. Corruption happened in Andalus too much. They sent another spy. The spy went to the youth, checking. Two boys were sitting in the same place, crying or weeping out, sad. Why? Because their girlfriends break out with them. They said Easter time. And they could go and they defeated them. And the Andalus disappeared. The Muslims were killed in Andalus in Spain in a way that till now you cannot imagine how they were killed. But they have it in the museums in France, in Louvre, and in some other museums in Spain itself. You will see how they used to kill the Muslims. I don't want to say because maybe you will have some nightmares. Really, wallahi, it's unbelievable how they killed the Muslims there. Why? Because they left the Quran. They turned away from the Quran and Sunnah. You have no support from Allah. So that's why this ayah is very important. إن قال الذين كفروا لا تسمعوا لهذا القرآن ولغوا فيه لعلكم تغلبون. The disbelievers, they don't want you to be attacked, to be attracted and connected to the Quran. And they know that this is your power, and this is your source of energy, and this is your source of success. And they will try their best to take you away from that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let us to come back to the Quran and to fix our relationship with the Quran. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease our understanding for the Quran, ease our recitation for the Quran, ease our memorization for the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the Quran the stream of our hearts, and make the Quran the light of our hearts, and make the Quran the most beloved things that we love in this dunya. Ameen. Alhamdulillah.